Hello, happy Monday, happy team call. Tonight we are going to do a super simple power hour because we've got some work to do. I just locked in Success Club 2. My goal is to have Success Club 6 by Wednesday. So I would love to see your goals as well. Drop them in the chat. Danielle is going to take off. Actually, let me do my Success Club first real quick. And then Danielle's got a couple announcements. Okay, so this, we just did the end of April update for the board. So not much has changed since last month, but Nina, brand new coach, is at the top of the board for adding people to the team. Congrats, Nina. She added 5. As of today, she has 6 PCs, and her husband didn't want her to sign up, but then he saw that she paid for 2 weeks of groceries of family of 8. And he was like, all right, you can sign me up. So go Nina, crushing it, proving hubby wrong. We're here for it all. And then Danielle has added 4. I added 3. And then Rachel, Amber, Laura, Melissa, and Rachel all added, Rachel actually added 2, but everybody else added 1. Congrats to everybody. And then Danielle crushed it last month with Success Club 20. Laura and Nina both hit Success Club 10. Huge shout out to them. And then Rachel, myself, and Melissa all with Success Club 6. So way to go, ladies. On the board, we've got Rachel, Matt, Brenna, Nicole, who's also a brand new coach of Flora's, Alexa, Dakota, Amber, Melissa, and Lisa. Melissa and Lisa also brand new coaches. So way to crush it, guys. Do you have slides to do, Danielle?
Yeah, it's within the same one you have. So you can just pull that up.
The power hour?
Yep.
Is this the right one?
Yep.
You added these? Okay,
cool. Yeah, think of 3 things.
Okay. I was like, can I just not look at this? I didn't remember this from earlier. All right, Thursday Power Hour on a Monday. Take it away.
All right, I'm going to start us in prayer. We've been saying we're going to do that, and we need to stay on top of it. Keep falling out of habit. So let's bow our heads and just take a moment. Dear Lord, thank you so much for the opportunity to be able to come together with our team tonight and just share this huge blessing of an opportunity we have with health and fitness. And we all know that it's just so much more than health and fitness, the way we can impact people's lives just by bringing the joy and bringing our love for Christ through health and fitness and through the community. Lord, we're just so grateful. Please help open our hearts and help us to receive tonight and just be open-minded and eager and excited about this opportunity that we get to share that ultimately is to glorify you, Lord. And thank you so much for all that you've done for us. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so I wanted to start this call with this analogy. Actually, April, will you stop sharing really quick? Okay, I have a $1 bill. And if I was to take this $1 bill and if I crumble it up, what is it worth? Like 50 cents or still a dollar? Still a dollar, okay. What if I crumble it up and spit on it? Still worth a dollar. If I throw it in the trash, I don't want this anymore, and it gets rained on and it gets all soggy. I hate that word. It's still worth a dollar. If I rip it in half, then what happens? Is it 50 cents? Is it 25 cents? You just tape it together and it's still worth a dollar. But see, here's the thing is a lot of times we go through life and we end up like this, right? We go through all this turmoil and all this crazy stuff and all these things that make us feel like we're unworthy or undeserving, or like we have no value to offer other people. And then we just feel like a crumbled old dollar that's worth nothing, when really Jesus made us worthy. Our value doesn't change because of what we go through. God made us unique and put us here for a reason, right? So our value doesn't change. We have a purpose. God put us here for a purpose. And just because you've been through XYZ, whatever you've gone through, whatever you're going through in your life, God has given you that to use. Okay. So turn your mess into a message and be proud of what you have to offer. Our new coach mentorship tomorrow or Wednesday is going to be over bringing life into your stories. And I like to talk about this because I think it's important to understand you don't have to have an exciting life, you have to be excited about your life. Be glad that you woke up today with air in your lungs, that you have a roof over your head, that you have food to feed your children, that you have a savior that died on the cross for you. All of those things are things that should ignite you every single day to share for other people that might not know about that. And I want you to think about those things as we go into this call, because we're inviting and we're really just getting grounded in what we stand for. April, you can go ahead and get started. So kicking it off, I would love for you guys to drop in the chat three things that set your soul on fire. What are three things that you think of that mean the entire world to you? Is it your spouse, your family, freedom, time? I just had a mom who just came home from her full-time job to be home with her baby and not go back to work. Actually, a couple. And it just gives me chills, because it's like, you will never end this life saying, I wish I would have spent less time with my kids. I wish I would have spent less time with my family. You're always going to wish you had more. You can never get that time back, right? So time is so valuable. Your family, I like that. Your future, so very important to you. Jesus, quality time. Those are huge. I want you to set your heart on those things, because when you set your intentions going into this business, going into inviting, you've got to have your mind right. You got to have your heart right. You got to have your passions in line. Why are you doing this? April, next slide. So set those intentions. When you get a fear of what are people going to think, or afraid of being ghosted or being turned away, like being told no. When you fear those things, I want you to ask yourself this right here. Pay attention. Are people's opinions of you more important than your family's visions and dreams? I know every one of us would say no to that. So why are you here? How important are those dreams for your family? And think about this. Imagine if you were the person on the other end, because you've been there. If you're here on this call tonight, you've been that person on the receiving end of that message, most likely, not like the unicorn that randomly signed up on your own. Someone probably invited you. Imagine if they had never dropped in your inbox. Where would you be today? I know if it had never been brought out to me, I'd probably still be living on food stamps, paycheck to paycheck. I don't know that I ever would have got my body prepped enough to get past the 6 years of infertility we went through. I don't know that I would have came out of postpartum depression or stayed active during my pregnancies or gotten healthy again after my pregnancy. I don't even know where I would be. And I don't want to think about that, because that sounds like a dark road to me. It's not about you. When we go into inviting and connecting and growing relationships, it's about that other person and what it can do for their lives, right? Every single person in this world benefits from improving their health and moving their body. Every single person in this world. I'll never forget a story someone on National Wake Up Call shared, where she said that she will forever, ever, ever owe her life and her family's life to her coach, because she was walking through the grocery store one day, and this was after she had completed, I think, a round of 80-day obsession, and her daughter started adding more healthy things to their cart, and she just looked in her cart and she was like, this is all healthy food. It's no longer Little Debbie's and Lay's chips and frozen pizzas and all this. Like, the impact of that changed not only her life, but her family's life and how she's fueling her children. You cannot put any kind of fear on that. You cannot put a price on that. That is priceless. So think about the person on the receiving end. Okay. Also, I want you to think that this is a job, J-O-B, job. April, you can slide. So most likely, if you're on this call, you want a business out of this. You're not just doing this for the discount. You're doing this to grow a business. So give yourself an audit right now. If we had a boss beside yourself, if your boss came to you and gave you an audit, would you be hired or fired? How is your work right now? When you sit down to work, what are you doing? Do you know what you're doing? And when you sign up, or let's say you get a job at, I'm going to use Cracker Barrel because this was me in college. I got a job at Cracker Barrel. I had to do X amount of hours of an online course to learn about Cracker Barrel. I had to study the entire food menu and memorize everything and be tested on it. That's just part of a new job. You start a new job, you have to learn about it, right? That's what coaching is. That's why we have new coach mentorship. That's why we have a PDF when you sign up to teach you about things. That's why we have team calls. We're here to provide value and teach you so that you can not only work on your own health and fitness, but do that for other people and grow a successful business. So are you working as this is a job? Are you treating it like a job? Are you logging into your online office, posting in the team page, showing up on team calls, a national wake-up call, doing whatever you can to grow your business? Give yourself an honest audit, and then what can you change? The good news is April and I are about to walk you through that and teach you. If you are one of those people, oh my gosh, I just noticed my husband and my sweet baby's on this call. if you are one of those people that you sit down, you're like, okay, I'm going to work my business. And you sit there and you're like, I don't know what to do. Or you find yourself scrolling reels or your feed and wasting time, which is not income producing. I love you guys too. And it's not income producing. Then this call tonight is for you. We're going to teach you what you're supposed to be doing when you sit down, whether you have a half hour or an hour, you're going to sit down and you're going to be doing those tasks. Because I don't know about you, but I don't want my kids seeing this all day long. And it's not creating freedom for my family. Without further ado. All right.
So April. Good. So good. I feel like this is like a message, like people just need reinforced, because it's so easy to let fear creep back in. And then you set goals. And then 2 weeks later, the fear creeps back in. So I think that that was so well needed, Danielle. And if you guys are watching, that if you're on here, we're so appreciative of you. If you're watching it live, I hope that you take that to heart, how really just inspiring that message could be. And one other thing, when you were talking about the dollar, made me think of this, like my biggest like motto is you are enough. And I recently started thinking like, yeah, but you are enough through Christ. And so like, for those of you that are building like a, like this faith-based business, and instead of like being so like, oh, give yourself grace, you are enough. Also too, this is another way of thinking about this that's really changed a lot for me, is that you're not enough. God has made us all. We are not enough. That is literally why he said, Jesus, we were not enough. We are sinners. We are just a bunch of knuckleheads. That's why he, you know, that's why he did what he did. Okay. But when you think about it, it's like, you're not enough and you're never going to be enough, but through Christ, he has made you whole. So take that when you're like, oh, what if I mess up? Or, oh, what if I do? Every single one of us messes up, because not one of us is enough without him. But that's why I love too, is when you pray before you sit down and work this business, when you pray over the lives that you're going to change every single day in the morning with my quiet time, I am praying over my business. I'm praying over my coach's business. I'm praying over, you know, Danielle's businesses. And I'm praying that God is going to align me with a woman that needs this, that's going to benefit her life, and her life is going to change forever. And you know what? I prayed that prayer. And today, a friend from high school who recently lost her husband, and father of their three sons, a couple months ago, and she just randomly messaged me. And I know that this community is going to be everything for her, because she needs something. And I'm so proud of her for putting herself first. So anyways, praying over exactly the type of woman that you want, or man, to, you know, connect with is so important too. So that was just my little, tidbit. Okay. So make sure you have a call to action. CTA is call to action in your stories and or feed. If you have not done that yet, what you can do really quickly is head to your stories and just say, oh my gosh, I'm so lit up about our May virtual boot camp. Who else is going to join us? And then just do like a little poll or something like that. So it's super easy, something you do. What I want you to do tomorrow is go through however you access your workouts, and go through and show them, take a story and show like your followers how you access your workouts. And then just a little poll at the end. Hey, do you want to try it with us? But walking it through how awesome it is and how easy it is. So connect through stories. This is in our new coach training today. We did the color wheel. So that's your homework tonight, is to go through and do that. And even if you're not a brand new coach, I encourage you to do this. It helps you with knowing what to post, and it helps you with knowing who to connect with. So make sure that you're talking about it. Are you a mom? Are you, you know, passionate about like holistic living? Are you like whatever you have passions and hobbies, even if you're
just a mom. Like I hear that a lot. Like, oh, I'm just a mom. Okay. Well, you do a lot of things and you're passionate about things other than like changing poopy diapers and doing the laundry without fail every day. So think about it and really sit down and have some thoughts there. So invite from stories. Hey babe, and say their name. Hey Angela, I saw you were following along my stories and just wanted to check in and see if you saw me sharing about gut protocol or whatever it is that you've been sharing about. I don't know if you already have a routine you're loving or if you've ever considered hopping in, but I'd love to chat more if you're interested. If I send some info your way, would you want to take a look? And there's so many different ways that you can phrase it. You can keep it super simple. That's just an example. So what I want you to do is we are going to set our, we're going to kind of do like a little bit of a speed power hour tonight since we did chat for a little bit. So I am setting a 6 minutes. You get 6 minutes. And we are just going through all of our stories. I don't care if you've invited them before, because guess what? You need to invite multiple times, sometimes multiple exposures. So go through your followers now and send a little invite, because this is like warm market. This is what people are already watching you. And if you need any other ideas of what to say, please let us know. We can type it in the chat, but I voice message everything. So. Some people think it distant, just some words on a page, but you're nothing more than feelings handed down along the way. But I've seen you part the wires when no one else could pull me from the deep. That's who you are to me. Some people think you just live in cathedrals made of stone, but I know you live inside my heart. I know that it's your home. And I've seen you in a sunset and in the eyes of a stranger on the street. That's who you are to me. You're amazing, faithful, love's open door when I'm empty. You feel me, hunger for more. You're mercy, your goodness, Lord, you're the air that I breathe. We'll be right back. time up. I'm like whispering. I saw Danielle was voice messaging. So time from that. So how did that go? How did that feel? Did you send messages? Were you pretending like you were working or did you actually send them? Please tell me in the chat. If you were pretending, let's talk about that. Were you doing something else? Were you scrolling? Because this is not the time to do anything except for what's on the slide. If you're doing something else, that's wrong. All right. Invite from followers. Okay. So here is an example. Hey, sister, I just wanted to reach out and say thank you so much for supporting my content and following my page. I know some girls like to just follow along for fun, for braids. Okay. Can you tell us, hook this from somebody else's? So I didn't make this or edit it yet. For braids or mom life, and some are interested in what I do, but are nervous to reach out. Let me know if you ever see me sharing about any of my boot camps and want to hop in. I'd love to send you some more info. If so, either way, just wanted to reach out and say thanks. You could make that super short and simple. And here's what I would voice memo. That's an example. I would say, hey, Emily, I just wanted to say thank you so much for being here in my corner of the internet. It means so much to me because sometimes I feel like I'm just blabbing like a crazy person. So I don't know if you're here for the easy meal plans or just mom life in general, but I'm thankful for you. Tell me a little bit about you. Are you currently doing anything for your health and fitness? Do you have any goals? I would love to support you. Let me know how I can pray for you. The end. So that is mine. If you have any questions or anything, let me know, but just keep it simple. I feel like if it's like word vomity, it's too much. So less is more in this circumstance. But any questions on invite from followers? So this is what you do. You go to your Instagram. So you go to your profile. Where am I? And then it says how many followers you have. So you click on that and then you can go through and that's who you're going to message. Okay.
Waking up to a new sound. Looking back from the other side, I can see now with open eyes, darkest water and deepest pain, I wouldn't trade it for anything, 'cause my brokenness brought me. And these wounds are a story you'll use. So I'm thankful for the scars, 'cause without them I would know your heart. And I know they'll always tell of who you are. So forever I am thankful for the scars. Thank you.
One more minute. Okay, I just wanted to share something really quickly. So I also am hosting a faith and fitness, like Ministry of Motherhood small group at my church. But because I'm doing that at my church, I'm also doing it in a online Facebook group. So my free community. But anyways, I tagged my church that I was doing it and they reposted, and I already have been connected with like six other local Jesus loving mamas that I didn't previously know. And so obviously those are perfect people that are like coach potential, and a couple of them. So I, during this time, reached out, set up, I'm having coffee with one of them Thursday, and I just randomly messaged her this. So we already have a coffee date set up, but she posted something about her working out. So I said, yes, girl, I want to chat with you about what I do as a coach too. It's so fun. Another great way to connect with other Jesus loving mamas. You'd rock at it. I just love your energy already. And we haven't even officially met. I can't wait to squeeze you on Thursday. So planting a seed before I actually like hang out with her in person. My big focus this year is building a local team. So getting involved in church, volunteering at church, going to like local hairstylists or coffee shops or things like that, and following and engaging with those people is a great way to do that as well. add to network. So this is something that you can do super simple. So I'm just going to set a timer for 3 minutes and you're just going to follow as many people as possible. What I like to do personally, because like what I just said, is I will go to a local coffee shop and follow anybody that's liked or commented on their recent post. You can do that with local hairstylists. You can do that with a local restaurant you love. If there's like a restaurant that's like, oh, that's totally my vibe, whatever it is, think of different local places and just go and it, because if it's people that are liking and engaging, that tells you they're active on social media. So if you have any questions about that, let me know. You can also do it on Facebook, whatever is your jam. Sometimes those voices try to tell me I'm forgotten and I'm falling too far from his hands. But I know what kind of God he is, and I'm trusting his promises and believing, and I'm seeing. Yes, he can. Did he move every mountain? Did he part every sea? Yes, he can. I just found out that, so we have a little coffee shop inside our church, and there's a church coffee shop Instagram, which I just discovered just now. And so now that is where I'm finding all of my people. You definitely love Jesus and coffee. You are my person. Okay, so timer's off. 3 minutes does not feel long enough. So I will encourage you to continue to do like another 5 minutes either tonight or some. I honestly, following and engaging with people is something that is highly underrated. I feel like you have no idea the one connection you can make that can change so much in just a day. And so I am really getting really clear at who it is I'm looking for. So then one other thing that you can do is go through mutual friends. So this girl from the church coffee shop, I followed her, and then she's pretty active in her social media and has a lot of people engaging with her. Now, maybe she'll sign up and that will be amazing. Or maybe she's just going to be a friend that loves Jesus and that's not going to be her thing. But she had a bunch of people commenting and stuff. So then I went through and I added in some of those people as well. Like, you can go in a rabbit hole very easily. There's no like lack of people. This is something that, like, if you're like, okay, what should I do? I have 5 minutes. Add people to your network. This is like a toilet tasks you can do on break from work, or you know, if you're hiding from your kids in the bathroom and you need 5 minutes alone, go ahead and connect with people. Because honestly, they're gonna go, and then I like a couple of their photos. And then what you can do too is you can sort by the most recent people that you followed, and then you have 5 minutes tomorrow. You can go through. If you were just following and you weren't really looking, then you can go back and say, all right, is this my person? Do I need to unfollow them? Kind of thing. But just wanted to share that. Okay. So where is my thingy? There we go. Re-invites or new invites. So honestly, when I like start a conversation with anyone, I know that it's going to be an invite by the end of my conversation. So, hey, okay, I know life is crazy and I totally didn't want to be a bother. I just wanted to make sure I checked back in case you were interested or wanted some more info. Just let me know and I can send some details your way. Excuse me. Another way that you can do it is, hey, I don't know about you, but I without doubt will open a message and my kids will need me. And then it's gone. It's in the black hole of my brain forever. So if you're like me, I just wanted to check in. I didn't want to just assume you didn't want a spot in my May virtual bootcamp. So I just wanted to check in with you. How was your weekend, by the way? And like, that's what I do. I let them off the hook by telling them, hey, look, I have a horrible memory. I just wanted to check in and see if that was you too. So we're going to go back through to people. I know, for example, I have 4 people on my list to follow up with that were supposed to join us in April and didn't. So I'm going to go through and send this kind of message to them. So we're going to put 5 minutes on the board and get to work. If you don't have somebody new or past invite, you're brand new, just go make connections and start conversations and ask people how you can pray for them.
wish I could say that's how I am, but I've been lying, yeah. Lying in my bed at night, one too many times I'm thinking, what if, what if? My biggest fear is waking up to find what matters is miles away from what I spent my life chasing after. Is my story gonna have the same two words in every chapter? What if, what if? The last I checked, this heart inside my chest is still beating. Well, I guess it's not too late. What if today?
All right. While doing that, I thought of something that I wanted to bring up too. While doing that, I had somebody else respond that I invited her, a different girl I invited earlier for coaching. And she was like, yeah, I'm always interested in learning more. I'm not responding to that right now because I finish what task I have. If you are like, oh, she responded, da, 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 then the rest of your power hour goes out the window. So I just like to point that out. All right, follow-ups. So this is, and also we just did a call on this 3 weeks ago. I can share that link to that in the chat. If anybody is like from Amy's team, if you guys want that, we can share that. But follow-ups are literally the bread and butter of my business. This is the reason that I've had success in this business. I like to use the example of Lisa, who is going through our new coach training right now. I literally invited her at least 4 years, probably more than that, to coach. And at one point she told me, April, stop inviting me. I am not going to do this. And then I just somehow started inviting her again, and she signed up and is a rock star coach. And she just lives and breathes health and wellness. So it just made sense. So I don't give up on people. I have a system of, I'm going to always follow up with somebody. And if they say no or ghost me or whatever, they're just going to go on to June's follow-up and I'll check back in with them, ask how I can pray for them, share a recipe or something like that. When I follow up, I always give some type of value. So think about what kind of value you want to have. Hey, it's me again. I know it wasn't the right time before, but I wanted to check back in and see if you have thought any more about joining in with me. I've got blank happening right now and I'd love to save a spot if you're ready. What do you think? I actually don't really, that's not something I would say. But here it's an example. And if that works for you, great. But my follow-up is going to be like, hey, Jennifer, I just wanted to check back in. I know we've chatted about it and life got crazy, but I am so excited about our May boot camp. And I just wanted to see if you are still interested in me saving a spot. Give me a quick update on you. How is life and how can I pray for you? And that is my follow-up. So if you need me to write anything down or share anything from that, let's go. But we are just going to do 5 minutes of follow-ups. Let's see what, this is actually our last thing. So I'm going to set my timer for 10 minutes and you guys can feel free to hop off after 5 minutes if you need to go, but I'm going to set the timer for 10 minutes. We'll close it out for a full hour. Danielle, anybody else, if you have to go, feel free to hop off, but get your 5 minutes of follow-ups in and then you can go.
and everything that I need, you've already given me. I remember how you told me I can trust you completely. So why am I doubting when you prove that you fight for me? You've walked me through fire.
Okay, time is up. I am going to sit here for 5 more minutes and send out a couple more invites and follow-ups. I'm going to go through the chat and see. Okay, I'll share the follow-up in the chat, but was this helpful? Can you guys let us know if this was helpful? Danielle and I have really been like trying to do all of our team calls for like brand new coaches and things like that. So I feel like we've done a really great job at doing that. But sometimes honestly, it just comes down to like just taking action. You don't need more training. So I feel like probably once a month, Danielle, we should just have a team call me power hour, because I think it's so helpful for new coaches to be walked through. Another thing too is if you look at the pin post, we have that third quarter power hour schedule. So there's usually almost every day, there's a couple of different options you guys can hop on. So before anybody else hops off, let me stop the recording. I forgot I was doing that still. So.